Let's talk about the relationship between cis and trans and axial and equatorial in substituted cyclohexanes. And I want to start with this compound, which has two methyl groups that are cis to one another. And a lot of times when we translate a structure like this into the chair form, since these groups are cis to one another, we want to put them both equatorial or both axial. So in other words, since this group is cis to this one, when I translate it to the chair form, people will frequently put both groups in the equatorial position. Now, this is actually not correct. And in order to see that, I want to look at a three-dimensional model of this. And what I've done in this three-dimensional model is I've represented my methyl groups as these larger aqua-colored spheres. And I've drawn the version of this where both of my methyl groups are in the equatorial position. And what I want you to notice is that on each of the carbons around the ring, if we go to each of the carbons around the ring, one of the groups is going to be axial and one of the groups is going to be equatorial. Also, one group is going to be pointing up and one group is going to be pointing down. It's usually really easy to tell whether the axial group is up or down. So for instance, this axial group is pointing down. This equatorial group is pointing slightly up. It's angled up. If I go to the other carbon, this axial group is pointing up. This equatorial group is pointed in slightly towards the down. If I look at my two methyl groups, one of them is pointing up, one of them is pointing down. That means that this is actually trans. And it's actually a little bit easier to see that this is trans in the structure if I fill in my hydrogens. This hydrogen is going down, so this group is going up. This hydrogen is going up, so this group is going down. This is trans. The actual correct chair form of this compound is this, with this methyl group pointing up. This methyl group is also pointing up. If I draw the correct form in the 3D model, I would have to move this methyl to here so that it looks like this, with one group pointing up, my methyl group here up, this methyl group also pointing up. One is axial, one is equatorial. If we look at another example, for instance, this 1,4 substituted cyclohexane, where the groups are trans to one another, since they're trans, sometimes there's a temptation to draw one of the groups equatorial and one of the groups axial. Like this. Equatorial, axial. However, this is not correct. Let's look at the 3D structure of this. I've got one of my methyl groups equatorial and one axial, and what I want you to notice is this axial hydrogen here is pointing up, meaning this equatorial methyl is slanted slightly down. This axial methyl group is also down, pointing down, pointing down. This right here is cis. If we want to draw the correct structure, we actually have to change this so that both of my methyl groups are equatorial, or I could draw them both axial. But what you'll see is this is pointing down, this is pointing up, this molecule is actually trans. If I want to draw the correct structure in my three-dimensional model, I actually have to move one of these groups. I'm going to move this one from the axial position to the equatorial position. So now this group is pointing equatorial and pointing slightly up. This is equatorial and pointing down. They are trans to one another. If we look at one last example, if we want to translate this chair form into the sort of more planar line angle structure for cyclohexane, we can do the following, and I would suggest we start by filling in our hydrogens. And what I see is that this hydrogen is clearly axial and up, so this is pointed down. This methyl is also pointed down, so this is going to be cis. So this is a lot like the first problem we looked at, except in going in the opposite direction, starting with our chair form and going to the more traditional line angle form. We could look at that on our three-dimensional model as well, like this, with this methyl slanted down, equatorial, this one pointed down, axial. They're cis to one another.